Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to different bond angles of molecules involved in covalent bonding. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question number 3. Which molecule does not have any 90 degrees or 180 degrees bond angles? Part A is C2H6, which is ethane. In ethane, carbon is making single covalent bonds. Each carbon is making four single covalent bonds, so the bond angle is 109.8 and the structure is tetrahedral. B is carbon dioxide. Now the bond angle in carbon dioxide is 180 degree because the structure is linear. C is phosphorus pentafluoride. Now in phosphorus pentafluoride, there are two different types of bond angles which are present. Three of the fluorine atoms are in the same plane, while two are not. So the bond angle here is 120 degrees, and this one shows the bond angle of 90 degrees. D is SF6. So in SF6, bonds are like this, two fluorine atoms. Four fluorine atoms are in the same plane. So the bond angle is 90 degrees, while the one above the plane and below the plane also has an angle of 90 degrees. So the answer is A. Question 24. Polypropene is an addition polymer. What are the C-C-C bond angles along its polymer chain? So we know that the monomer is like this. We have double bond present between two carbon atoms, and rest is the number of hydrogens. So when a polymer is formed, it will be like this. This will be the repeat unit. So in the polymer, we can see that the central carbon atom is attached with the other elements with single sigma bonds. So there are four covalent bonds around the carbon atom. So the structure is tetrahedral, and for tetrahedral, the bond angles are 109 degrees. So A, they are all 109, yes. And there is no 120 degree, no 180 degree, no 120 degree. So the only answer is part A. Question number 5. Histidine is an amino acid. This is the structure of histidine. What are the approximate bond angles 1, 2, and 3? According to valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, double bond behaves as a single covalent bond. So therefore, for 1, we can see that this carbon has no lone pairs of electrons, and it is making 4 covalent bonds, out of which this bond will be considered as single covalent bond for the shape. So whenever there are 3 atoms surrounding the central element, the bond angle is 120 degrees. For second one, we can see that nitrogen is making 3 single covalent bonds, and also there is a lone pair of electron present on the nitrogen atom. So the structure will be trigonal pyramidal, and the bond angle will be reduced from 120 to 107. For third, we can see carbon. Again, carbon is present and it is making 4 single covalent bonds. There is no lone pair around carbon atom. So the structure will be tetrahedral and the bond angle is 109.5. So looking at the given options, we have 120 degree for the first one, 107 for the second one, 109.5 for the third one. So therefore, correct option is B.
Question number 3. Which molecule or ion contains the smallest bond angle? A is ethene, as we have two carbon atoms and four hydrogen atoms. So there is a double bond between two carbon atoms. When measuring bond angles, double bond is taken as single bond. So therefore, there are three bonds around this carbon atoms. So the bond angle will be 120 degrees. Similar is for this carbon atom, the bond angle will be 120 degrees. B is CH3COCH3, which is a ketone. Let's draw the structure. We have three carbon atoms. And there is double bonded oxygen with the second carbon. Three hydrogens with the first one. And three hydrogens with the last one. As we can see that CH4 carbon is making four single covalent bonds. So the bond angle in this will be 109.5. Central carbon is making one double covalent bond and two single bonds, so the bond angle will be 120 degrees. C is NH4 positive, and in NH4 positive we have three single covalent bonds and one coordinate covalent bond. As the structure is tetrahedral, so the bond angle will be 109.5. Part D is ammonia. In ammonia, we have three hydrogen-nitrogen bonds and one lone pair is also present on nitrogen. As the repulsion between lone pair and bond pair is more, so therefore this bond angle will reduce from 109.5 to 107. So the compound having least bond angle is ammonia. The answer is D.
Question 1. Which feature is present in both ethene and polyethene? Ethene is C2H4. We have double bond between two carbon atoms. The structure will be like this. In polyethene, polymer is formed from these ethene monomers. So what happens that double covalent bond is converted into single covalent bond and long chain of carbon atoms is formed. A, bond angles of 109 degrees. As we can see that in ethene, three atoms are present around the central carbon atom. So now bond angle will be 120 degrees. While in polyethene, around central carbon atoms, four bonds are present, or four elements are attached with single covalent bonds. So the bond angle will be 109.5 degrees. So option A is incorrect. B, pi covalent bonds are present in both ethene and polyethene. As we can see that in ethene, pi bond is present along with sigma bond. The first bond is always sigma bond and the second covalent bond that is formed is always pi bond. While in polyethene, we can see that all bonds are sigma bonds. There is no pi bond that is present. So B is also incorrect. C, sigma covalent bonds. Now we can see that sigma covalent bonds are present in ethene and sigma covalent bonds are also present in polyethene. So therefore C is correct option. D, sp3 orbitals. Now hybridization of orbitals can be found by looking at the central atom. In the first one we have ethene, so the central atom is carbon. Now carbon is directly bonded to three other atoms. So we can write 3 plus number of lone pairs on carbon, which is 0, it equals 3. If the number equals 3, then it will be sp2 hybridization. If the number equals 4, then it will be sp3 hybridization. If this number equals 2, then it is sp hybridization. And also the shape of orbital is sp3 or sp2. Similarly, in polyethene, we can see that the central carbon atom is bonded to 4 elements directly. So it is 4 plus number of lone pairs, which is 0. Now 4 means that the hybridization is sp3. So we can see that in polyethene, sp3 orbitals are present, while in ethene, sp2 orbitals are present. Therefore D is incorrect. Correct answer is therefore C. Question 32. Which molecules and ions have a bond angle of 120 degrees? 1. We have BF3. Now we know that boron is having 3 electrons in the outermost shell and it makes 3 single covalent bond with fluorine atoms. So as we have only 3 bonds with the central atom, so the bond angle is 120 degrees. So 1 is correct. 2 is CH3 negative. Now carbon has 4 electrons in the outermost shell. And there are 3 hydrogen atoms. So each hydrogen atom is making single covalent bond with carbon. We also have a negative charge, which means extra electron is present. Now there are 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair is present. The repulsion due to lone pair is greater, so therefore bond angle will reduce and it will get similar to that of ammonia. So 2 is incorrect. Third one is NH3. Again, in nitrogen we have 5 electrons in the outermost shell, out of which 3 electrons make single covalent bond with hydrogen atoms, while 1 pair is present in the form of lone pair. The bond angle will be 107. So 3 is also incorrect. As only option 1 is correct, the answer is therefore D.
Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.